Hey everyone, this is my review of What If Episode 3. I'm just going to get right into it. Usually I start by giving my overall thoughts and then I go scene by scene, but I feel like maybe it's better if I just skip the scene by scene, kind of cut out the filler and just give you my thoughts. I think everyone listening to this watched the episode, so I don't need to go scene by scene. And I thought this was a fantastic third episode. I don't think it's the best episode. I think the second episode was the best one. But this one might be my favorite episode thus far because of the genre, the tone, the mystery. I love that. I love a good mystery. So, first thing I thought was really good and I loved about this episode was the plot, the twists and turns. Again, the reveals, it kept me on the edge of my seat. I love the reveal of Hank Pym being the murderer at the end and that he was motivated by Hope's death. I love Loki. Being Nick Fury, we thought it was Nick Fury until it was actually Loki pretending to be him. The animation was fantastic again. I do think it was a little more clunky in this one again. It's weird because the first one I thought it was really good for action scenes, and then dialogue was a little clunky. The second one I thought was perfect for both. And then this one I feel like, again, the action scenes were great. I do feel like some of it was a little clunky, but not a huge deal. I thought for the most part, it looks really beautiful and I'm liking the style. Another thing I loved about this episode was the tone. So many moments were like kind of brutal. It's not even that it was gory or that it looked brutal, but it's the way it was done and the music and the overall tone of this episode and the mood of this episode, the way it made you feel. I felt creeped out a little bit and like the music, everything, it felt like a murder mystery. It didn't feel like a superhero story trying to do a murder mystery. It felt like a murder mystery. It felt creepy. It felt scary. It felt like there was a real threat here and something was going on. And all the Avengers' deaths really hit hard. They had an impact. You're like, oh, wow. And they felt brutal. And I like that about it. And you know, I'm just a big fan of murder mysteries. I love murder mysteries. Knives Out is one of my favorite movies ever. So this episode is just in my wheelhouse. I loved it. I love that in this episode, the Watcher did something different because in the first two episodes, he revealed the decision that made this alternate branch. Like in the first episode, he said Peggy's decision to stay in the room made the branch. In the second episode, Yondu's decision to outsource and to have his crewmates pick up the kid created the branch. But for this episode, he doesn't actually reveal the decision. That's part of the mystery until it's revealed later in the story that Hope joined SHIELD. And that ultimately was what happened because she was sent to the mission instead of Black Widow. She was killed by Winter Soldier instead of Black Widow being shot. And then that sets Hank on this path where he goes and tries to kill all the Avengers. I love that. I love how this episode centered on Nick Fury, Black Widow. Nick Fury is always kind of a supporting player in other stories. Of course, he's going to be in Secret Invasion, but I still feel like that's going to be an ensemble show. It's not going to be a Nick Fury show. So it was great seeing him kind of front and center. Black Widow, too, she's always been underrated. She's always been one of my favorite Marvel characters. I like how she was the one to solve the mystery. I liked her little fight scene where she broke out of the truck. That was cool, showing her abilities. The cliffhanger, I love the way this episode ended. This is one of those what ifs I want to return to. I want to see more of this universe, whether or not that's in later episodes of this season or something to be picked up on in season two, with like Loki taking over the world, with Captain America and Captain Marvel, Nick Fury finding them. I just love that reveal too of Captain Marvel at the end. That surprised me. Another thing is I love how they incorporated the Hulk into this episode. I love the way he died too. It was surprising, but then also Betty Ross being in this episode. I love that Marvel is acknowledging Incredible Hulk now because I do like that movie. I don't think it's a bad movie. It's definitely one of the weaker ones, but I don't think it's just flat out bad. And I think they need to bring more aspects of that movie back. I'd like to see more. And I'd like to see Hulk have more of a spotlight. I'd like to see Mark Ruffalo as Bruce Banner have a lot more screen time, get a lot more development, get a lot more story because he's really been relegated to the side. And I know there's that Universal deal, which restricts Marvel, but it's just a bummer because I'd like to see more of him. Because Hulk feels like a huge wasted opportunity. And this episode is the one that really solidified how much I love this show's concept, the show's premise, how bought in I am to the show, because this is what I want the show to be. Every episode, a wildly different story with different characters, exploring different genres like murder mystery and different tones. One can be more goofy, humorous, one can be more heist, one can be more creepy like this. I like the exploration of different genres, of different tones, of different ideas in the Marvel Universe, and then following familiar characters in different ways. Like, I love just Hank Pym popping up in a like a more Avengers-centered story, or Captain Marvel popping in at the end. That's always really fun to see. And that's everything I really liked about this episode. I have some criticisms. Again, I thought the voice acting was a little bit inconsistent again. I thought for the most part it was pretty good, but there was some moments where I was like, it's not as strong as episode two, and it's more akin to episode one. Not a big deal. I heard some people complaining that maybe there were some plot holes, but didn't bother me. I just wanted to mention that. And then I do feel like the humor is not as sharply written as most Marvel things. I felt like some of the jokes were kind of the easy jokes. Not a big deal. This is an animated series, but the humor was still funny, and I thought it was delivered well, but it definitely was not up to the level of most Marvel things. So that's all my thoughts on What If Episode 3. I love seeing Nick Fury and Black Widow take center stage. I love seeing all the characters, the cliffhanger, the murder mystery, the kind of creepy tone, everything about it I really loved. I do think Episode 2 was the most perfect and the most objectively better episode, just in terms of the voice acting, the animation. But I think if I were given the three and I had to choose my favorite, Episode 3 would be my favorite. Please let me know what you think. One thing is, I know I haven't been uploading as much on the channel, and I apologize for that. Life has gotten much busier. Everyone can understand that. I'm going to do my best to keep doing these weekly What If reviews, probably bi-weekly news roundups. I will be talking about that No Way Home trailer, the next news roundup, and occasional reviews and other stuff. For example, I'll be doing a big, probably half an hour Shang-Chi review once that comes out. And once Star Wars Visions comes out, I'll be reviewing all the episodes of that. So there's still stuff coming. It's going to be less because I've been busier, but there's still plenty of good content coming your way. Thank you everyone for understanding. Please let me know what you thought of this episode. Did you guess that it would be Hank Pym, that he was the murderer? Let me know what you thought of this episode, this show. There's a form in the description where you can submit discussion topics, questions, theories, anything you want to be read aloud and discussed on the show. There's also an email to be read aloud if you want to leave longer thoughts, a voicemail if you want to speak your thoughts, and you can, of course, leave a comment on YouTube, and all the links to do all those things are in the description. So thank you, everyone, for listening, and have a good day.